Good morning, it's Monday, November the 8th, and you're watching Agoracom Small Cap News TV Resources Edition here every day exclusively on theglobeinvestor.com. I'm your host, Paul Kandakos. Agoracom TV is a daily, fast-paced show, bringing you the best press releases out of the resource sector at the open, along with the halts, so you can hopefully profit from them and potentially find your next great small cap investment. Folks, hopefully you all had a tremendous weekend, but it's Monday, it means it's time to get down to business. I've got three great press releases for you. Actually, correction, I've got two great press releases for you, both out of the resource sector, and I've got two halts in the second segment of our show. So without any further ado, let's get down to business. Our lead story comes out of a company called Midway Gold Corp. They trade on the TSX Venture under the symbol MDW. They also trade on the New York Stock Exchange Amex, also under the symbol MDW. The company is announcing higher grade golds are present in their last three core holes drilled for metallurgical testing at its 100% controlled Pan project in White County, Nevada. We've got assays coming out of hole number 10-6C, which reported 46.3 meters, grading 1.4 grams per ton of gold. Additionally, we've got 90 meters of 0.8 grams per ton of gold, and that's coming out of hole 10-09C. So respectable numbers coming out of Midway this morning. Last at 61 cents, high of $1.04, low of 38 cents, market cap of approximately $55 million. Moving on to our next company, Claude Resources. They trade on the TSX under the symbol CRJ. The company is announcing their third quarter financial operating results for the quarter ended September 30th, 2010. They're a junior gold producer, and they're recording net earnings of $4.3 million or 3 cents per share. And this compares to a net loss of $400,000 year over year. So it looks like they've just gotten into production and they've been boosted by the fact that gold has been on a run in and around the $1,400 per ounce level. If you like junior gold producers, this is one you might want to take a look at. They're last at $1.70, high of 172, low of 92 cents, so they're in and around their 52-week high, market cap of approximately $223 million. Moving on to the next company, no more companies, I've got two halts for you. Baffin Island Iron Mines Corporation on the TSX, halted pending news, and Stratic Energy Corp on the venture under the symbol SE, halted pending delisting. And actually, I've got one more for you. Drift Lake Resources on the venture under the symbol DLA, halted pending news. That's a wrap for today's show. Thanks for joining us. Please make sure to join us again here tomorrow on The Globe Investor. We've got more great press releases and halts coming out of the small cap resource sector.